What's up guys, TechSecPro with a new one. In this demonstration, I'm going to be teaching you how to work with the remote package sender and installer in order to transfer games from your computer to your jailbroken PS4 and install it automatically via local area network or LAN instead of using USB stick or hard drive. Okay, cutting to the chase, first thing first, go to GitHub repository link that I put it in description below. Scroll down till you reach the assets. Then download PS4 Remote PKG Sender zip file into your computer. Here it is. Make a new folder and call it RPS. Open it up, then drag and drop the zip file inside the folder. Right click, extract it here. Now sort the files by type. Then right-click on PS4 Remote PKG Sender version 2 and open it up with administrator privilege. Cool, here is the user interface. We need to download one more file, which is Remote Package Installer, because first, we gotta send a package with this software to the PS4 via network, and then PS4 receives the package and installs it with the Remote Package Installer inside its hard drive. That being said, you gotta click on MISC's drop-down list, then click on Downloads. Go for first one, Remote Package Installer by Flats, and click on Download. It immediately directs you to the Mega Upload Center where the file is hosted. You simply click on Download and save it on your computer. Here is the file. Now go to PS4, Settings, User's Guide. Gold hand. Wait for USB insertion message. Here it is. Plug the exploit USB stick and wait for unsupported file system message. Here it is. Now hit on OK and I'm all set. If you don't know how to make USB exploit for your system software version 9, then you better watch this video tutorial to learn, and if you are on the system software version 5.05, you gotta watch this video to learn how to jailbreak your PlayStation 4. Great, back to settings. Network. Enable connect to the internet. And finally, connect your console to your DSL router either with LAN cable or wireless connection. Awesome. Back to settings. Gold hand and enable FTP server. It's ready. Great. Back to computer. Go to filezilla-project.org. Click on FileZilla client. Click on download FileZilla client. And finally download it. Okay, here is the file. Double click to install it. I agree. Next. Next. Next, next again, and install. Finish and start it. Back to PS4. Settings. System. System information. 192.168.1.103 is my PS4 IP address, which needs to be entered into FileZilla FTP client. Back to computer again and enter the IP address here. 192.168.1.103. Of course, yours could be different. And the port number is 2121, but the port number is always the same. It doesn't change, guys. Click on Quick Connect, and I'm connected to the PS4 hard drive right now. Click on Data folder to browse. Drag and drop Remote Package Installer we already downloaded into this folder to transfer. Transfer finished. Nice. Back to PS4. Open up Internal Package Installer. If you're not familiar with Internal Package Installer and its mechanism, you better watch this video tutorial that I already made, which will walk you through installation and the usage with details. So, as soon as I open IPI, it detects the remote package installer PKG file that we already drag and drop in the data folder and starts to install it on the PlayStation 4. So, I open it up, add it to the download, installing, and here we go, ready to use. So far, so cool. Now, open it up and let it be running in the background. Back to computer again. FileZilla, data folder again, find the remote package installer file that we already drag and dropped, right click on it, then delete it, cause it's installed and only takes up the free space of the PlayStation 4 hard drive as a junk file, so we don't need it anymore, we have to delete it. Alright, I'm done with FileZilla, so I close it. Open up remote package sender. Click on config. For the server IP address, click on drop down list and choose your network adapter, which in my case is wireless. Yours could be different again. Don't touch the port number, which is 8337. Down here, for the PS4 configuration, enter the PS4 IP address that we already checked, which is 192.168.1.103. Alrighty, done with configuration too. Click on processing center tab. Click on check server. Cool, as you can see it's green and says Heartbeat is working. Awesome. Now click on the check PS4. It's green and accessible too. That's an awesome sign, which means that I am all set to install games on my PlayStation 4 remotely. Okay, here's the deal guys. If you encountered any error messages relating to connection issue, try to add the port number 8337 as an exception in your Windows firewall. And if you don't know how to do this and you don't want to go through the complications, then you simply turn off the Windows firewall temporarily and try it again. If it didn't work either, then close both remote package sender and installer. Open them up back again, which I believe that will fix your problem. Alrighty guys, the game I'm gonna install and test is Backgammon and Blitz because you know it's not that much heavy and it's good for this demonstration. So click on config tab and from the PKG base path, you simply click on this icon to choose the path. Then select the folder which contains the game. Get back to the server tab. Click on reload. Here is my game listed below. Click on plus icon that the game goes into the queue and waits for installation. Click on processing center. And click on PS button to check whether the package can be installed or not. Here it is. Seems like the package that I'm gonna install doesn't have any problem. Great. Now click on start button to install. As you can see, added to download list pop-up message appears in PlayStation 4 and the game is installing now. Because my PS4 and laptop are connected wirelessly, the speed of the file transfer is not fast enough. But if you want to have the fast connection, then I suggest you connecting your both computer and PlayStation 4 to your DSL router with LAN cable instead. The advantage of remote package sender and installer is that you can run a game and play it while the installation is on the go in the background and you don't need to wait till it's finished. And that's super cool guys, isn't it? Alright, installation is finished and here is the game ready to play. Don't forget to join my community on Telegram group to meet and play online with the people on your jailbroken PlayStation 4. If you never had a chance to learn how to play online on your jailbroken PS4, you gotta watch this video tutorial that I teach you how to do this. And after learning it, I highly recommend you watching this short video to know how to meet your partner or opponent to play together online on your jailbroken PS4. The next video that I recommend you to watch is this one, which teaches you how to run your own server at home to play online on your jailbroken PS4. All of these videos that I suggest to you guys are totally related to one another, so I put the links in description below for you guys to check it now, and that's the end of this video tutorial. Thank you for watching and have a good one. Subscribe to DexTech Pro YouTube channel.